This year, Sony released the back button attachment for the PS4, and in this video, I'm going to be taking a look at how it's best used for Red Dead Redemption 2, specifically online. Does it have a place in this game, or is it just another throwaway gimmick accessory? So, for those of you that aren't aware what this attachment is, it's essentially Sony's long-awaited response to the functionality of controllers from brands like SCUF. The attachment adds two buttons to the underside of your standard PS4 controller, making the use of the fingers that usually just act as support or are unused when playing PS4. A common use of this functionality is seen in first-person shooters like Call of Duty, allowing people to jump in the air or drop to the floor while still being able to keep their thumbs on the analog stick to aim. In games like COD, jumping or dropping to prone makes you a more difficult target to hit, and in PvP modes, split seconds can make the difference between getting a kill or being killed. So, with that being said, my first test of this device in Red Dead Online was to explore its use in PvP. A feature of the back button attachment is that it allows you to custom map buttons based on what you need. You can scroll through three preset modes relatively easy using the screen on the back. The key for me here was to highlight playing techniques in PvP, be that showdown series or just free roam fights, then working out which buttons would be most useful on that attachment. With auto aim being a main feature of the combat in Red Dead, diving to the side, which temporarily breaks an enemy's auto aim, is something you still see a lot in PvP modes. Currently, on normal controls, to do this you need to remove your thumb from the right analog stick and hit square. This briefly stops you from being able to use the analog to aim. So, mapping dive slash jump to one of the attachment buttons allows you to continue aiming even when hitting that button to dive. Then, hopefully, when you're flailing around on the floor, you can line up your next shot and take out that enemy. Now, we already know that diving is a very useful thing to do in PvP modes, so mapping it to this button attachment really does make sense. That's one button down. Now we need to map the final back button. The best button I've found for this second spot is R1, your cover button. We all know that the cover system in this game can have its issues, and unfortunately for the majority of players, R1 is how we get into cover. And the reason I say it's unfortunate is because it means we're hitting that button and taking our finger off of the trigger momentarily. If you find that the cover for some reason isn't locking, you may get tempted to tap R1, creating even more time until you're back on that fire button, making you an easier target for your opponent. Putting R1 on one of the back buttons means you can retain your finger on the trigger, and much like I said with diving, every split second counts. So this may sound like a really minuscule benefit to having this back button attachment, but it could mean the difference between a kill or being killed. I've got to say though, I do feel that mapping it to the cover button is very much secondary to diving. I think diving is the absolute priority, especially when using this accessory in gunfights on Red Dead. So that's all good and well for using it with PvP, but as a result of my survey show from my last video, only 12.9% of players play PvP modes. So what about the 87% of people who don't seek out gunfights with these matches? What is this attachment useful for in non-PvP? This is an interesting one because the real benefit to this accessory is that it speeds up your play, which is obviously most useful when fighting someone, but maybe not for the more relaxing style of free roam. Well, here are a couple of uses that might help you out. In a video I did a while ago, I gave details of the best controller settings for Red Dead, in which I suggested that you use a mode that switches your sprint and your crouch buttons. If you don't have your sprint button switched and you're still sprinting by spamming X, then the back button attachment can be mapped to X, so again your thumb can go back to taking care of the analog, which in the context of free roam would mean that it's taking care of looking around. This isn't only useful for PvP. For example, if a flock of heron is just out of your reach, we all know every second counts to try and bring them all down. So being able to sprint or jog while still keeping your eyes on the target in the air is very valuable. There's a definite benefit here to mapping sprint to a back button, as even if you've got the button switched to alternate, on your horse you're still required to tap X to run. So you can use that same principle on the back of your horse. Of course, tapping a back button to sprint is something that you need to get used to. It's not something that comes naturally based on all the controllers that have been made for consoles in the past. Once you get it down though, it is useful. For the other button, there isn't really anything that jumps out at me that could be useful in this context of free roam, hunting and things like that. Maybe you could put triangle on the back, so rather than having to press triangle, you press it on the back so you can carry on looking for targets when you're hunting. But really, that doesn't save you much time at all. If any of you've got suggestions for what this button could potentially be mapped to, then please let me know. I'll give it a go at some point and see what it's like. Overall, in terms of whether this attachment is worth purchasing purchasing solely for use with Red Dead Redemption, for the majority of players out there, I wouldn't bother. It's only going to be the PvPers out there that would really benefit from the capabilities of this attachment, and the free roamers won't find much use for it. I'm not saying that the back button isn't a good product, but I think it really comes into its own when it's used on games like Call of Duty, and even racing games really, with manual gear shifting. If you already happen to have the attachment for use on another game, but also play Red Dead, hopefully you can get some use out of this video. But as I've said, the attachment isn't hugely useful for this game. So I advise against getting this accessory for the free roam side of Red Dead Online. And to be honest, unless you're a real hardcore, competitive and regular PvP player, don't bother either. It cost me just under 30 quid, which I think is reasonable as it's been on my controller since the day I got it and has really upped my game, to be fair, on Call of Duty. On Red Dead though, like about 87% of people, I very rarely play PvP matches, if at all. So I haven't got a lot of use out of it for that game. Let me know what you think in the comments below about the use of this attachment in Red Dead, whether you have it, whether you want it, or don't see the point in it at all. I think we can all admit clamping a couple of extra buttons on your controller is a sweaty, try-hard thing to do, and to be honest, I'm embracing this little bitch move that I made. I'll have a video coming out soon about what the attachment has done to me, so hopefully you'll enjoy that. Pre-warning though, it's not focused on Red Dead, so sorry about that. I'm breaking away from Red Dead just a little bit. Anyway, if you enjoy this video, please give it a like and subscribe for more. Don't forget to comment on any uses you can think of for the back button attachment, and check out the essential controller settings for Red Dead in the video on screen now. Stay safe. I'm JM Cookie. Cheers.